Jesus, by his life and ministry, gave an example for how his disciples were to live and follow him. And we see so many instances in all the pages of the gospel where Jesus sets that example. Today in the gospel from St. John, it's a very beautiful, touching gospel, because we see the intimate love that Christ has for his heavenly Father. He's speaking to him from his heart. He loves him with his whole mind and heart. And he speaks to him so personally. And what he's doing is praying to him, and he's praying for you and me. It says, you gave them to me, Father, and I have glorified you in them. And I have told you what I came to tell them about you. It's a very touching thing, and I've always felt a great deal of hope and confidence when I read these words of Jesus praying for me, praying for you. And he still does that each day, prays for each and every one of us. And we say we pray for each other, and what a wonderful feeling to know that Jesus prays for us. The St. Paul in the first reading also says so clearly, he had also the same example of Jesus. He was concerned with doing the Father's will, and he was concerned with everyone that God sent him to teach. Here in Ephesus, he's proclaiming to them how he lived among them and how he taught them the Word of God. And then he knows that his time is coming to an end. His enemies are going to seek him out and take his life. But he's so willing to do it. He says, I serve the Lord with all humility and with tears and trials. And then he goes on to say that I consider life of no importance to me if only I finish my course in the ministry I received from the Lord Jesus. He truly is completely devoted to God, to doing what the Lord sent him to do. And we can say the same thing about God and us, that he sent us into the world. He created us. He gave us life. And he has a purpose for each and every one of our lives. What it comes down to, there's been millions of words written about the meaning of Christianity, but it comes down to one word, and that word is love. Love God, love your neighbor. If we do that, if we want to know if we're doing what Jesus wants, we just need to look over a day and say, how much did I show love for God, and how much did I show love for my neighbor, anyone whom I encountered. And if we do that each day, slowly we take on the heart and mind of Jesus. Here at Mass, he feeds us with his own body and blood, so that on our journey to eternal life, he may accompany us into his kingdom. Let us stand and offer our prayers and petitions.